Hello everybody, Thorgal here, and welcome back to my modded Let's Play series. I was very busy playing around with these NPCs and really understanding them, so I can show you guys today on how to use them and so on, I think in a much better way than last time. And I was very busy between episodes. Can I get over on this tree here? I don't think so. I think that jump is too far. Let's try it with the glider. Come over here. Open it. I didn't make it. All right, let's just fly over here. You guys see it grew a lot. I was, like I said, very busy adding a bunch of these buildings with the, what are they called again? The construction workers, NPCs, these guys right there, the craftsmen. I actually made three altogether to help me in this house here. You guys remember the door, I think, was over here. So I actually tore this whole thing down and put the mats back over because I didn't need to count and everything. And then I turned it around to build it. And, well, let me just show you. Now it's much better aligned because I would have had the two doors on the side. So now you can come out here and you are at the fishing dock. You guys remember this here? Oh, let me turn down the sounds a bit. What would those guys be? Friendly creatures, right? I think those are villagers. And I just put two little fishing chairs here, and this is where we're going to put the fisher in a second once I show you the rest of the village. I completely secured it. There it should be no dark spots. I double and triple checked everything, and it's been many nights, and I've never seen anything over here. Over here, I had set up two crop farms. These I just built by hand, because if you want to use the craftsman to build this, it actually wants you to put farmland and for each one of these, like 7 buckets of water. And I'm like, yeah, okay, I'm just gonna build this by hand. But I added a lot of little houses also. And you guys see, I got 4 villages. I got this white coat, a brown coat, a yellow coat, and a green coat. And I picked them up from over here, from this village right next to us. I have not checked the NBT data yet from the server file, if this actually counts as a village. I kind of wanted to see, get the surprise if eventually I'm going to see a little baby, but we have lots of doors. So if this counts as a village, then we should get new villagers here soon. And some of these little houses, I just put a little bit decoration, you know, just chest and crafting bench. And this is that town hall. This one I actually just built myself. It's not a village building. I wanted something a little bit different. And over here, you guys see, I fenced this off. Because these knuckleheads come over here and they think they can walk and then fall in the water. And then they can never get out again. So, and I also needed to put a fence gate up here because they just love this bridge if I don't have that. So yeah, this is the little village. There's blacksmith building here. Ooh, check this out. When this was finished, it even gives you loot. That's kind of cheaty, I think, because you can just keep building these. Tear it down, build it, tear it down, and you keep getting free loot. So I left it in there to show you guys. I'll sort this out later. And oh, what are you doing up there, mister? Man, if these guys find something to climb, they climb it. Oh no! How did you get out? How? Unbelievable! How did he get out? Let me get a golden lasso. That's the ones I used. Recipe's a little bit expensive, but it's fine. I had these, the blaze flowers from the desert, whatever they're called. How did you get out? They cannot jump fences. I don't think he can jump from that leaf block. He can't get up there. How did you get out? They can climb over this. Man, these guys, ooh. No, he can't get out here either. I don't know. Anyways, let's go get busy with setting up the villagers. I prepared a bunch of stuff in this bag that we made last time. These are all the different farms I want to set up, and the... I did make the courier. Ooh, that scared me just a second, but the courier doesn't need a block. So let's start over here. Like I said, if they find something to climb, they climb it. We're gonna set up our town hall right here in this building, because that's our town hall, and then we're gonna decorate it and stuff later on. And I don't want to spend too much time on these guys today, like I said. So this is our town hall. And the first thing we're going to do is... I cooked some potatoes up over here. You guys see I got 49 levels because I did a lot of mining between episodes also. And put this here. Alright, I also learned what the death list is. Your villagers can die. I guess from getting killed by zombies or whatever. And then they show up here. And if you have a priest... It's this one right here. You can resurrect them. So we definitely probably going to have to add a chapel or something. How's it going, man? Face down into your bed. Let's go ahead and sleep. So to make sure we don't have any surprises right now. And bam, there we go. So I do want to set this up in a little bit of a different way. So what we're going to do is first place all the farms. And then we're going to tie... the cards to it that we need, because as soon as you place these, they start running off like knuckleheads. Did I make this flush? Yes. So we're gonna leave the fisher over here, like we had, and hopefully this guy will not run off. I think he will only come to like here and then do his job. He actually doesn't do the fishing. And I learned a lot of thanks to Glitch. He was teaching me a lot, helping me a lot. He's played with this mod many times before. What we needed for our fisher was not a fishing rod. All farmers, because this counts as a farm, need hoes. Okay? And I did some testing in a single player world today. With the different types of hoes. I put two capacitor banks next to each other and gave both of those a... That was the only way I could figure out how to test it. Where is it here? Automation? Yes, and I put a right there here, the hand crank torque generator next to each of them, and then I gave one worker a wooden hoe and the other the hammer, because you need the hammerer guy to crank this. I gave one a wooden hammer and the other one a diamond hammer, and the wooden hammer guy made about average of 11 RF a tick. While the diamond hammer guy made an average of about 15 RF a tick. So that's what these actually do, these NPCs, okay? When they come here to work, you see them right clicking, or you know, swinging their hoe, I should say, the entire time. And then you see the RF of the farm go up. So all they do pretty much is powering the farms. They don't actually do the fishing or the mining and so on, which is kind of sad. I wish it would be like that. Okay, so I got the work order for the fisher guy. I'm hovering over this and I'm pressing, I'm gonna take the front face, Z. So now position is added, one. He's gonna come here to work. Let's close all these doors just to make sure, because I want to make sure that he can pathfind, ooh, I got turned around there. He can pathfind properly. Okay, and now I'm gonna take the upkeep order. That's this thing here. And I'm going to bind it to the town hall. And what that means is, get your food from here. Okay? That's what that means, pretty much. You can have multiple town halls, so you can reduce travel time and so on. But I'm okay with it. And I believe also when it turns night, all of the villagers are going to come in here. So I can only set up... You see a little guy out there? How you doing, buddy? I can set up guards in front or only around this house, and that should be enough when I need it. All right, so... Let's get this fisher guy out. This worker right here, that's one of the first ones. So he should have a lot of health. Bam. Yeah, 30. And I'm going to first give him the upkeep order. And I don't know if he had food or he took some already. And then we're going to give him a... hoe. And then... the work order. And now we should see him go. Thank you for closing the door in my face. And he's already coming back to get more food, I'm guessing. Hello? Excuse me? What you doing, buddy? Work order is set to the fisher. Can you not path there or something? No. Will you go in there and go fishing? Ah! Alright, stop. When you shift right click them with an empty hand. Stop running! You lazy butt. Why can't I not get in this door? What's going on here? Shift right click, follow me, noob. Let's go. Let's go. What? Where? Where's the baby? Alright. Okay, now shift right click. Are you still having that symbol? And he's running away again. What is happening? Alright, I want to find this baby zombie. He's annoying. Get out of here. And you too. Leave my villagers alone. Alright, I don't want to carry this around. Did I get another one? No. Alright. I'm not sure why this guy isn't working, guys. I have no idea. I've not had this problem before. Let's close this again. Let's see where he's hanging around. He's not here. Where'd he go? Is he maybe fishing now? He is standing there. Alright, so now he moved. You guys see fish farm 1500 RF. So when it catches a fish... I wonder what this guy's problem was. Why did he... Maybe he ran away because there was zombies? Maybe they have that logic. Hey, enemy, I'm gonna run away and hide in my... That's actually pretty cool. And this should get a fish here pretty soon. You know, it's random. Just like fishing. I just wanted to show you guys that when it catches a fish and the RF goes down, that then this guy will start working again. Okay, I've been AFKing here waiting for this guy to catch a fish. This zombie came near here and instantly this guy started running away. So I have an idea of what to do. They all seem to be aiming over here because I'm guessing there is no fence. So I'm going to make an archer and place that guy right up there against that fence. Wow, this guy's tough. So now I want to see, there's no more threat. And this thing still hasn't caught a fish, but he's back. I think this is awesome. I like that logic. I did not know about it. Alright, I don't have any more time to wait for this guy. I'm pretty sure I can show you on another farm. So let's set up the next ones. And I think the next ones I want to get going with is the crop farms right here. Now my problem is I want to place these crop farms in a way so these guys hopefully don't walk on top of it and then trample it when they step off like they could possibly do over here. I guess it doesn't make any difference because they're just going to replant it. All right, so let's just set these up. So I made two of them because, well, these guys are going to need a lot of food. Let's put the first one here and the second one here. And you guys see that they are a little bit smaller than the area I actually want to farm. So what we can make here is make a different upgrade. And that is... Did I really only bring... what? Okay, I'm doing something wrong here. Give me that. Let's just use the recipe right there. Oh, it needs to be an AW crafting. Man. Let's go over there real quick and do that. Oh, by the way, thank you very much for that tip. To make a second research book. So that's what I did. Right-clicked it so it tied to myself. So I have one in the researcher and one in this AW crafting here now, so I don't need to move them around. Yeah, there we go. I wanted three of those. Let's go back up there, and I might be able to get in. No. All right, so let's come around here. Is there a zombie again? Wow. Yeah, I need to set up some defenses over here. Because this fisher is never going to do anything. Has he caught a fish yet? No. Weird. That is very weird. This is usually a very efficient farm, but whatever. Alright. Coming back. The names I'm going to think about between episodes. Who I'm going to name who. Or maybe towards the end episode. So, check it out. You hold one of those and then shift, right-click the farm. And it just upgrades the radius. Now, to show you the comparison, when we go to bounds, you guys see we have a 5x5. We can move it around and resizes, but never bigger than 5x5. But this one now bounds, bam, we got a lot more room, right? So what I want to do is, this is west and east. So, nope, not this one. So that one too, and then I need to move this one towards the east. So like that, you guys see, and now we got the new bounds and it's exactly this one crop field. I might actually be able to take a bigger upgrade and put it in the just in the middle and then cover both fields, but we're just going to use two for right now. There we go, bounds. So that was bigger here and then east. And we cover both of them. Very nice. So now let's set up the two work orders first. So this one is going to be the left one. And this one is going to be the right one. And our fisher should be in here because it is night. So that's okay. Have you eaten? You already ate two potatoes. It's going to be pretty crazy keeping up with this. And I need these two as well. I think they're both assigned when I do this. Well, we'll see in a second. Alright, so get these two guys out. One and two. And you get the upkeep order here. And you get the upkeep. They're not leaving right now because it's night. That's why we see that symbol up there. And you're going to be the farmer for the left. And you the farmer for the right. I'm pretty sure I could actually only use one of them. Because there really isn't as much. But I want some life in this village. And there we go. We got the next two. So, yeah. Let's go ahead and sleep. And we should see these two guys instantly running out. So yeah, I'm going to set up archers here. I'm going to make them here in a couple minutes. I got to see if I need any research for that. But there is something to do. So now check it out. You see the RF coming up on this crop farm on the bottom right, 320. It did something, so it went down. And this guy, that's what he does. And you see, we're starting to get stuff in. Things it replants, it puts in here. And I'm actually very interested because we have carrots over here. This one is only potatoes because I'd like to have potatoes to feed my guys. Okay, which we're going to set up in a minute. So, now we got two more farms, right? Three. Let's do this one first. The animal one. Which is going to be... I need to make sure to keep it away from the fence. Because if I put it here, we're going to have these guys over there jumping on it and then dropping in. So, let's put this here. And I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to upgrade this one. So I need to move this over. One, two. Alright, so he's going to stand over here. Now, the other thing is we got to go to other. Max pigs. For now, I want to see how much it is. I just want to keep two pigs, two sheep, and two cows. Chickens I'm not doing here, so I'm going to set them to zero in case one flies in. And he should be... Oh, killed it. Why is it not picking up the items? They're there. Are these just glitched there? Let's see if they're actually there. They are. See, anything you put... excuse me. See, anything we put into this, when you throw something in there, the machines are supposed to pick this up. Why is there only one now? What? Alright, I'm not sure why that didn't pick it up, but I need to extend this one over. Or, I'm just not going to mess around with this anymore. and make this one smaller, even though I thought it was cool to have a little... Watch this. Now that I'm breaking this, I'm gonna have 9 villagers run in here. No. Good. And I think I'm gonna make this one wider this way. So if it kills something, I wanna make sure it gets the drops. What's the point of this? Right? So let's put this guy in here. Bounce. So that would be... That would be this way. So that is east-west. So west? What is the... Is that this? No, it's this. There we go. Alright, cool. So we got this guy working. And of course, what we can do here is check it out. I'm just going to show you here. Let's take 4 because that's all I have right now left over. You see, it instantly fed them. And there's a baby sheep and a baby cow. And because I'm setting this down here to only keep 2, I believe once these 2 babies are grown up, it's going to kill one of the parents. So it's a very slow and steady supply of wool and leather and so on, which is perfect. Oh man, I said I didn't want to spend the whole episode on this, but lots of derping here. So next one we're going to set up is the reed farm and the tree farm. And put this right there. I did want to put a tree farm, and this right here I just added before the episode because I don't know, I didn't know where else to put it, and I kind of like this spot here with the sand. And I'm not giving these either an upgrade, okay? So I'm going to put in, let me just shift click this in here, sugarcane into this one and saplings into this one. And let's set up the rest here real quick. So I'm going to need, these 2 can be the same. So left is reed, Z, and this guy is the tree farm. Oh, did I make an axe? I did not make an axe. Hopefully, stop pressing the wrong buttons. Oh, by the way, check it out. You guys know I've been eating boiled egg, right? Recipe for that is egg in the smeltery, and today I did 16 more. And it's the same recipe, but today for some reason I got omelets instead of the boiled eggs. So I wonder if this is just going to be a random chance or... I don't know. yes, I wanted to get 1, 2, 3. Tell me I got 2 sticks. Perfect. Let's make an axe real quick because we need an axe for the lumberjack. There we go. And then this upkeep order right there. Okay. It's always the same, you guys see, but I wanted to set these first villagers up with you all. So there we go. Open this, give it an upkeep, and this is going to be our reed guy. And I didn't give you a tool yet, fella. Where are you going? Knucklehead? There. So now this guy should be planting. It takes a while, but you see, RF is coming up. There we go. It's starting to plant this. And I don't know. I have not used this before. We'll see how efficient it is. But we can never have enough paper, right? And now get this guy out here. Upkeep. Axe. And there we go. Now you guys see it says lumberjack. He has a different color shirt. These guys are so rude with the doors in my face. And I'm wondering if it's going to chop down this one eventually, or if the leaves are going to get stuck on it, and so on. I don't know. And you know what? For the time being, I think... Where are my shears? I went through a couple of these. Because I wanted to cover this one up here. Make it a little prettier looking here with the... I didn't want to have torches. Why is there a torch? You gotta be kidding me. Can I hang you here? Alright, no red spots. Good. And let's take down this tree so it's gone. Even though I really like these. But we're gonna have hopefully lots of trees over here very soon in the farm. And turn this off. So, now that we have all these guys working... I wanted to try one more thing, and that is I want to set up a courier that takes... How are we going to do this? There's let's just use one furnace. We don't need two. That way I can keep up with the charcoal easier. All right, so let's get this guy out and place him down, and then we'll talk about what it does. I need these two and done. So here's our... Let's do it in here. Bam. And we're going to give this guy this small backpack right here. And now he is a courier, okay? And we're going to set him also upkeep here so he knows where to flee to and all these things. But I don't think he's going to start doing anything because he does not have this one right here. This is a routing order. It's not a work order. Oh my lord, the doors. Let me sleep so these guys be quiet. Unbelievable. I love villages and so on, but the door noise always drives me nuts. All right, so what do I want this courier to do? I want this courier to pick up potatoes from over here. So let's do it like this, because I want to make sure this guy has a pretty good pathing system, okay? Because they otherwise get stuck on a lot of things. It's a little time later now, because I had a lot of trouble figuring out this courier. And then I did a lot of babysitting here and making sure everything is working properly. Ooh, that's a big tree over there. And I also wanted to make sure I can show you guys some progress. And I did a bunch of crafting of things here that we're going to need for the rest of the episode. So, we're talking about the courier here, right? The upkeep order is tied to the town hall. And I wanted to show you guys what I did with the routing order. How to make it work the way I wanted it. And he doesn't have anything in his bag right now, okay? I have it selected so you guys can see the different points I set. Right here. I set the last one to be the town hall, which is fine. So it's actually starting over in this area. First, number one is I send it to the crop farm. And it is important that when you select the crop farm, to take things out that you select up. Because you remember that I told you earlier that these machines here, when you go to the sides, top, up, top, that's default here, okay? You can only extract from the top of these machines and only input from the bottom and from the front, which I believe is this one here. What? Let's see here. That is north. Does it say north? Yes, right there. It's where you can put in resources, which would be the potatoes here, okay? So right now you guys see there's 11 in here, so we're gonna keep that in mind. So I tell him with this work order up, and this is the one that I had the most problem with. By default, it's set to fill target, which would mean fill the crop farm with whatever you have in here. And how I understand that it works is if I have one potato here, it will try to put one potato in there. And if there's already one in there, it will move on. That's it. Fill courier is the same reverse. Take one potato. If you already have one, move on. And correct me if I'm wrong with this, guys, because I'm not 100% sure, but the way I have set it up now is the only way I could get it to work, okay? Deposit match. That would mean deposit potatoes. And I believe it does not matter the amount here. And take match. That's what we want here. Take potato. So there's 11 in there. He should take 11 once I give him the work order. Number two goes to over to this furnace right here. That's number two. And on number two, I am saying furnace up again, because in the furnace, vanilla furnace, you can only input from the top. Deposit the match. Deposit as many potatoes as you can put in there. Then number three is the same furnace. And I'm saying down because you can only extract from a furnace to the bottom, right? Take match, all baked potatoes. And then we're going to the town hall, which apparently doesn't matter what side you do. Deposit match, all baked potatoes. This is the most important one here. Any other setting I had in these fields, it was wonky. Okay, this guy was running around with like a stack of raw potatoes, a stack and a half of baked potatoes, and he never deposited anything. I don't know. It's got to be those settings. All right, so This one should work. Like I said, his bag is empty. And now when I give him that, he might do some wonky things here. Oh, I gotta tell him to stop following me. He does go back there first, okay. He likes doing this also. He likes to get stuck on this fence. Move. I should probably set up a few more routes on the floor. So instead of having the straight line pointing to there, you know, point to here. And then from there to over there and so on. Let's see. He clicked many times. Let's stop him real quick. And I bet she has 11 potatoes in here. 12 now. Perfect. So he took all the potatoes, and that's what I want him to do. And now he's going to go in there first. Nope. He does. Sometimes he goes different. And he put all the potatoes in there. And now he goes in there. He doesn't have any baked potatoes. So he just runs through the house back to the crop farm. You know, it looks easy now that I'm explaining it, I hope. But it took me a long time to figure out why I could not get this guy to just take them all. It was weird. So now, there's a few baked potatoes. Did he already take them? No, he didn't even come over here. Okay. He took them. Let's quickly go in here and let's see how many there is. 3, 6, 4, 10. 6, 6, 4, 10. So now he put all the baked potatoes in there. So this guy is now finally working, and I'm very happy about this. Now, it's been... I was dinner for an hour. And before then, I made a watering can. And then just did the old rebinding of the key trick and just stood here. Because the problem is that these three slots need to fill first. And now the access goes up here. So this he only takes from out of this top field, okay? So it took a while to get the potatoes to actually catch up. I noticed one other problem in this field here. You guys see there's only wheat now. This used to be carrots. And that is because it plants whatever is in the first field. Okay, so now if I want to have carrots, what I'm going to need to do is switch these. And you see, now there's carrots. So now for a few cycles, it will plant me only carrots. But for now, I want more wheat than carrots because I don't really care that much about the pigs. The only reason I need pork chops is to make more of... What are these things called here? These right there, the food bundle. That's the only reason I need pork chops. So very cool. We finally got this guy out of the way. And I found villagers three times out in the water. And the only way I could explain it is that they fell out right here. So I put the fence around it so nothing can... I don't know how... If they get out again, I don't know where. I can't explain it. And I wanted to show you guys this right here. Check it out, how much fish there is. That is just in here. I'll show you more in a second. And I actually went down here to other and unchecked harvest ink because I set up a chest in here. I already have over 4 stacks of ink sacks. Look at this. That's why I said earlier I was kind of confused why nothing was happening, but that was simply just because this block was one too high up. It's a very efficient fish farm for a couple baked potatoes. I love it. Another thing I wanted to point out is these machines are not smart. When they're full, they will start spilling the items. Okay? So I put these drying racks all over the place. And I'm like, all right, let's say, you know, I got enough fish. I really don't know what to do with it anymore. I simply go to this guy, for example, say repack, so I have them in my hand. And then I hang them on the drying rack like this. So if I ever need more fish, I take them out and just place them here again. And he's back to the way he was before. And I have this at every single station. There's one right here for that farmer. One right here for that, and one over at the tree farm, at the reed farm, and also at the animal farm. Okay, now I would like this to grow a little bit faster, the stuff here. So I made a tank and a sprinkler from open blocks. I'm going to need to, let's take this one off for a second. And we're going to place this tank right here. I also never mentioned that you guys see my iron pickaxe, and it has the diamond... tips now. I left that one modifier a long time ago. When I made the pick and I left this one, we only put 2 moss. And I finally put the diamond on yesterday. And I was able to mine the obsidian finally. So I got 30 something obsidian. And that's what the reason why I was able to make this tank. It takes 4 obsidian to make 2 of them, so I have 1 spare. But anyway, you place an open tank right there. And then we just gotta fill this here for a moment. It shouldn't take too long. I think they hold 16 buckets, right? Let's just fill this up real quick. And then I can never remember which way you need to place the sprinkler. If I place it like this, is it... Let's just place it this way. Yeah, I did it right. Cool. And this sprinkler now, even though we don't have any bone meal in it, does increase the growth rate in the area. So it's gonna go to... Looks like here. And that is... What is that? 4 to each side. And I hear a zombie again. Where are you? I also hear a skeleton. Where is he? Is he down there again? Well, my worker is still here. Hey, buddy, why are you still here? It's nighttime. Did I mess you up? Why are you... Did this get reset? No? Town hall is there. I have no idea why this guy is just standing here. These workers are still there also. But these guys all came home. It's interesting. Okay, I want to see if he runs out when the morning comes again. Alright, they all came out. But this worker back here, and that's the one I tested it on with earlier. I picked him up and hung him there. It's full. Okay, I don't know. Maybe it's just a little bit of a thing here. Okay, so we got the sprinkler going. It goes 4 in both directions. It's going to help a little bit with the growth rate of the potatoes and the wheat or carrots if I want those. The other problem I've noticed is I have a lot of item spillage over here. Look at this. And, I've been babysitting this for, since the last cut. It's quite some while now. Quite some time now. And I've just been putting everything in here with hand. It's very efficient. You look at this. We got 18 stacks of wood already. But I made an advanced item collector. And we're going to set this one... We're going to set this one to the top. Why not? And right now, it's not going to do anything. Check it out. If I put something right here, it does pick it up. It does put it in. Interesting. I thought that the sides... Top. Up top. So... Apparently, it does pick it up and put it in. So what I want to do here is I want to set up an item filter. Sorry, I didn't even show you guys, but I'm sure you can figure out the recipe. Just 4 yellow dye around a piece of paper, and this guy needs ender pearl. And let me just show you. It doesn't matter. Recipe right there. First diamond, 2 glowstone with the item collector, which is a hopper, an ender pearl, obsidian stick, which is, bam. Two pieces of obsidian. Okay. So let's put this up here. And we're going to put this item filter, which I need to set first. Right click it with an empty hand. I only want to allow apples and saplings. Ignore meta. Whitelist. Yes, that's what we want. And put that in here. And let's see here. This is 5 radius. So I want to have, because I see them falling all the way into the water over here. So let's just make this. It doesn't matter. It's only allowed to take up this one item. So I'm just going to set them all to 10. It doesn't matter. So if I drop this sapling over here, it's going to pick it up in the apple. So I don't need to worry about any more of these things going missing. But. Because I actually want them to go into the resource slot. So right now it puts it in here instead of in here where I need them. Because if this first slot is empty, it's a bug that Glitch and I found out. It doesn't plant anymore, even though there's more. You need to have saplings in the first one. Now let's test this again real quick. So let's take this. Let me take the filter off. I guess I could have left it in the top. Let's leave it at the top. I like it better there. Sorry about that. But we're going to switch the sides. So the front is north front. Let's say this one is front. And then from now on, extract would be the top, which is now the front. Sorry. It makes no sense to me why they worded it like this. But it's fine. Once you understand that, it's not too bad. So, we have 60 in here. Now we got 63. What happens if I drop the apple? It doesn't pick up the apple. So I would need a second. But I really only care. I don't care about the apples. As long as it keeps the resources full, I'm actually happy. Okay, and what else do we have? Yes. The other thing is, every single night I have zombies coming over here. It is bananas. It really is. And all these workers, then the next morning, they don't come out. They don't do anything. Or they run out and come right back. Because the zombies are out there, right? So let's set two more work order upkeep orders right there. I'm doing good on the baked potatoes. Hopefully it's going to pick up a little more. Oh, I might be out of... Nope, it's still going over here. Still have 18 charcoal. Okay. Sorry. So we got these two upkeep orders. And we're going to set up these two here. I did a little bit more research for conscription or something, I think. And I made these two combat NPCs right here. Okay. And they both are going to get a bow, so they become archers. Next episode, we're probably going to reskin them and name them and stuff, guys. I don't have time for it today. And I believe we can even give these guys... enchanted weapons, enchanted bows and so on. I just picked them up again so they're ready because I want to set this up first, the combat order. So that is a different order, just like the courier. Just crafted with a sword, I believe, right? No, with the red dye. It's the different dyes. Black, gray, light gray, and red we have used so far. So this one archer. Sometimes I've seen zombies come from over there. They came this way, okay? But they all end up going down towards that end, okay? But I think one of the archers should come over here. So we're gonna say... I want them to be patrolling. So one is gonna be here at this spot, position added. And then I think we're gonna have him... I don't want him to walk through here. In case they grow, he might get killed. So I think then we're going to have the second one come to here. And then we're going to have him take a look here. And then here. So he's looking out over there. He's looking out this way. And then we're going to have him come back to this one. To this one. And then to here. And look out this way, because most of the zombies are coming from the island over there. I can't even explain why, because there's no place for them to spawn. I don't get it. Okay, so that is it. It's going to patrol between these spots. And then the second archer... Well, let's just get the first one going, I guess. I can just place him down right here. Bam. Here is your order, sir. Do your job. No, he's just gonna stand there, look around. I don't even know if I can give them any other... Does this thing have any other options? Just go there. And I'm guessing if they find something, kill it. Okay, I see a problem with this tree farm still. Because now... Again, if it keeps these saplings full, that's all I care about. If these few despawn... So be it. Okay, and then the second archer we're going to set up real quick. We are gonna come to Z right there. Come here. Come here, looking out this way. Then come back here. 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 And here. And I guess here. Okay, and then just to make sure, I think you're gonna be fine. So let's put this guy down right here. And by the way, these guys do not go inside at night, the combat NPCs, which is where you want them to be. Where you don't, you want them to be outside when it is day, when it is night, of course, because that's when you want them to be shooting. So I really hope that before the end of the episode, I'm gonna see one of these guys attacking. So that is that. And now we have one last thing to do, guys. Oh my god, this episode is bananas again. But you are used to that by now, I think. You picked up baked potatoes, I think. I don't want to have to keep up with the charcoal, okay? I was thinking of just taking the wood, for example, and putting it in here, but there's another way. I want to use ancient warfare power. So I made these things. Yeah, I had to research mathematics and then gravity, okay? And the recipes are simple. You just need a bunch of gear, three of them iron. And this down here is just lots and lots and lots of wood. That's all, okay? That's all you need to make these shafts and so on. And I decided I'm going to use an external heater from Immersive Engineering. This one is made with one redstone, copper, and iron. This is all just copper, everything. So it's all quite cheap. And I had this blocked off for the time being. So none of these knuckleheads runs in here. And I guess I should probably start from this end first. Ah, don't want to pick this up. Get it out of here. Where am I coming out over here? Right there, it looks like. Right? Okay. So let me put a barrier here for the time being so I can get in and out, but none of these guys can. Right there, and they can't come in here. Okay. I'm just worried because once these guys start running, I might miss it or something, and then I gotta hunt them down. So right here is where the power is gonna come in. And I am going to have to figure out a way of making this work. I think right here. Okay. I think that might work. Let's get a stone brick and put that right here. And we're using this water wheel generator right there. But it is not spinning. I need to make this so it is spinning. How can I do that out here without... I guess I can tweak this here with some stone... Oops, is this... No, that's fine. Like this... Can I put a block here? Yes. I need to empty the water in there. So then the water will rush into here once I break that stone brick. There we go. It does work. Perfect. Where you at, Archer? No? I want the Archer to kill you. Leave me alone. Archer, over here. Over here. Why is this farmer coming out at night? Like, come on, come on. You were almost there. You're useless, mister. Yes. Shoot him. Shoot him. Shoot him. Look at him in the water wheel. Sweet, they work. I might add a few more here once I have the baked potato going. That was nice, not bad. About 5 shots, right? Very cool. I have no idea why this guy is coming out at night. Maybe he's a little confused when day and night is. Okay, so we got the power going here. And what we need to hook up here first, whenever you do a 90-degree turn or something, you need one of these junctions here instead of the actual shaft, okay? That's this one right here. And my buddy Glitch told me a really cool trick that I wanted to show you, because I always had problems getting these things to line up the way I want them. And he said, always start at the receiving end. So that would be this furnace here, right? Well, actually, not the furnace, my bad. We got to put this heater here first. And the way you have to set these up, by the way, is you have to wrench this with the engineering hammer. Just right-click it. And now I set this to power input, okay? So right here, we're actually just going to have a shaft. And it automatically places it in the correct direction. And then I'm going to try to click against this, another one. And here we're already coming over. Oh, I'm turning around. Where am I going? Here. And again, now I'm going to click with the junction. And then again with a shaft. And you can wrench these with a crescent hammer or any other wrench, of course. Oh, okay, I need one more. Right there. Okay, again, I'm gonna need some air here. And hopefully I can... Yeah, I should be able to click on this. There's another junction. Another shaft. And then another junction. And you see? It's gonna take a second, but they're gonna start spinning. I like how this fence wants to connect to it. Okay. But let's go around and make sure... No, get out of here. Where's my fence? Let's close this off. Okay. Let's see if this is actually getting power now. It still says 0 of 32,000. Alright, I believe that there's a problem that these guys cannot directly power a machine. Okay? So what I'm gonna need to make here real quick is a... I'm gonna just make a... Here we go. Leadstone flux duct with some redstone glass and lead. Alright. I get these leadstone conduits made. And now I believe if I put this there... You guys see? It's charging with RF. So for some reason, you just cannot connect the torque shafts directly to it. Now, I don't know what these are for, by the way. I played around with them. Where is it? This one right here. There's these energy storage. They say light flywheel controller and light flywheel energy storage. I don't know if those are usable here. I could not figure it out. So if you guys know what else we could use here from Ancient Warfare, please let me know. But anyway, so this guy now has RF and it's heating up. And the this is out. Is there something I can put in here to cook on me? So, you just shoot him, dude. Why are you running around? Just kill him. I hear lots of doors going. Alright, anyway. Let's get a piece of sand. Whatever. There we go. And put that in here. And you guys see? It is powering it just like if you have charcoal in there. Now, of course, it... Oh, it's done already. It only uses RF when you actually smelt something, so you don't waste the flame or something. So that is really neat. You know, I'm thinking here is possibly just having these guys stand at a spot instead of having them patrol. I think that would be more efficient. But for now, it's fine. Guys, do I have anything else on here I wanted to show you? No. I know it was a very long episode again, and I'm not really sorry for that, because I'm having fun, and I hope that you guys are enjoying it. I am not aiming to make episodes that are this long. Just wanted to let you know. It just always works out this way with me, because there's so many things I want to get into an episode. Let me know how you like the village. What other things do you think we should add here from just in here? Before we cut out now, what I think my next step is going to be is I would like to... I don't know if we're going to do a next episode, but the future of this village, what I'd like to start doing is get a courier, then to start bringing all the excess things and bring them here. into a cart loader, and we're going to start bringing that over with rail carts to our main house, which I am definitely building next episode, okay? We're going to build a nice big house here, probably going to time-lapse us or something, because I'd like to have a place, you know, instead of living out in the field right there. But anyways, I hope you enjoyed the episode, and I'll catch you in the next one. Take care, stay safe, and bye-bye!